Hi everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2018 Tierra 38 LS. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer.
Okay, so here we are, and I want to start out at the bow, just kind of giving you a real profile of the vessel. Tierra is known for building an outstanding quality constructed vessel that actually handles fabulously out on the water in all types of sea conditions. We're going to start out here and you're going to see the nice stainless steel anchor system that they've done to really integrate into the bow system itself. It also really complements the lines. As we move our way around, the vessel itself is painted with a beautiful bluish gray metallic that ultimately kind of changes colors and the different lighting. So it really gives you multiple different effects as we kind of move around the vessel, which really makes it stand out quite nicely on the water. As you can see, we have a nice foredeck area up here. Underneath that hatch, there is the windlass control, the windlass, and everything is nicely accounted in there in that anchor locker. We have pop-up cleats. There are three on each side. So again, making it really nice to maneuver around the vessel, not being able to stub your toe on anything, but have those out in place. We also have a nice bow section here, which I'll show you a little bit later as we move up to that area. But there is a Mediterranean sunshade that goes over the top of this, and it is quite outstanding. This particular vessel has almost every option you can imagine on it, also including the teak trim inlays throughout the vessel. But again, as we move our way back aft, you can see just how beautiful the lines are, how ergonomics have been really brought into it to make maneuvering around this vessel quite nice and enjoyable. One thing I want to kind of point out, you'll see from the listing photos, as this aft bench seat will actually pivot around facing aft and or facing forward. The table itself will drop down and turn into a filler cushion, so it makes that into a nice large lounge. So it is quite impressive of what this area does, which you'll see from the listing. We have triple 350F Yamaha outboard, so we have great power, great fuel economy, stainless steel propellers, and again, this vessel has been kept in the most pristine condition. Also had a brand new bottom paint put on it here in December. As we walk aboard the vessel, underneath this hatch is our swimming ladder, so that allows us easy access into the boat in the nice, beautiful teak aft deck here. One thing that's quite unique is we also have a flushing system on the vessel for the outboards, so that's where you would plug the water into and it flushes all three of the outboards. As we move up, you're gonna also see we have nice gates that'll kind of enclose the aft cockpit here. So if you have small kids or animals on board, this is a nice option here. And then as we move up, we're gonna also see this opening hatch here. This will allow us for our shore power, air conditioning shore power, and then we also have the outboard flushing system. So that's a really nice upgrade that's been done and really designed quite well. I like it how they have the shore cord, how it's easily accessible, and it kind of brings it out here to the back, so it's not a bulky cord that you're kind of stepping over. Just below our feet here is a large storage area that's both true to starboard and port side. Centrally located is our kind of components room, which I have an additional video that you'll see on that, but it's amazing. We have the generator, the Seakeeper, and all of the systems. Okay, so we're heading down into the components room for the 38 LS, and just below us here is the Seakeeper, and this is a DC Seakeeper, so this will actually run off of your DC system. Just above that is our three filters for the Yanmar engines. And then we also have a Vectron Energy charger, and then a second charger here set up for the house battery bank. We have all of the steering pump controls here, all of the Yanmar controls. We have the huge DC battery bank, and this is all AGM batteries with some breaker switches that are located there. As we work our way back, you're gonna also see filters and again, access points to bilge pump. And this is an amazing area. This is our diesel fuel cell. So this is supplying the generator with the fuel. And then again, we have start batteries back there.
There's also a oil changing system for the Onan generator. And as you can see, this is the generator itself. So really amazingly well fitted, nicely installed. And again, this space right here can be utilized for lots of storage, for stand-up paddleboards and what have you. Nice aft facing seats here. There is a large 12-volt refrigerator here, a drawer, we have a sink. And again, look at the attention to detail from just the craftsmanship, the woodwork, and the integration of the materials that they've used here. It is quite nice. This is our Kenyan grill. And again, it's held up by gas shocks here. And this is a really nice system. We also have a trash can here. There's also a mount for a flat screen television that's mounted under this as well. And again, as we look aft, we're going to see just how much usable space is on this vessel, on the aft deck. And again, it really just incorporates, you know, quality from everything you see, all the materials that are used on the seating bolstering and how this is designed. If you're looking for a really nice, high quality vessel, you got to take a serious look at this. Okay, as we're going to be moving up forward, we're going to be walking around. We have these nice deep gunnels here. We have stainless steel grab handles. There's also grab handles above head as well too. And again, these are attachment points for the Mediterranean sunshade that goes over the entire bow. But this is a great place just for lounging and hanging out. Again, nice big seating areas here. The attention to detail from the armrest to all of the stitching that's gone into this, it is quite superb. We also have armrests on both sides, but again, you can see just this wraparound windshield. So when you're at the helm, again, you have 360 degree visibility, which is pretty spectacular. There's also a separate zone for the stereo system up here that's controlled by this Fusion remote. And again, as I mentioned earlier, we have the anchor locker here. This is the windlass. We have our controls, there's a freshwater washdown, and that's integrated up to that really nice bow roller. I like how everything's on gas shocks and closes quite nicely. We also have the Tierra, you know, labeling on all of the hatches. It's just, again, it's just another detail that has just been taken into account and really makes this vessel stand out. So here we are going to be looking at the helm seats. There are three helm seats here. Obviously, we have great visibility. There's a built-in ice maker down here. We have air conditioning, heating vents throughout this area. So this cockpit can be fully enclosed and are all opened up if you so desire. We have 16-inch Garmin displays here. We have our trim tab controls, bow thruster, our Yamaha controller here. So this is the ignition for all, start all, and or you can do them individually if you so desire. Throttle system, and again, just the attention to detail with the Tierra Sport logoing on the wheel itself. We have the joystick controller here, and then we also have the position stay button, which will keep the vessel in one position or into the wind. Really makes it nice if you're single-handing or short-handing the vessel by putting out fenders and dock lines. This will really give you that peace of mind you're looking for. But again, you look at all of the switching and everything and how it's inlaid, just beautiful high-gloss varnish wood. It is pretty spectacular. We have the compass up forward, nice detail stitching here on the dashboard. Looking up forward, we have our Seakeeper control, we have our Yamaha display, excuse me, and then our Garmin autopilot. So this can also be all integrated in with the Garmin displays as well. So these are just backup systems. We also have really nice JL audio speakers throughout the vessel as well. So let me give you a little look behind us here so you can see what this is. But again, all the use of space and everything that they've done, especially these helm seats, are pretty impressive. We also have foot bolstering here, and you'll see from the pictures that this lower step right here will come down and create another platform so you can have better visibility if you need to. But lots of lighting throughout the vessel. There's LED lighting all on the inside of this. There's an overhead opening hatch for great ventilation, and again, additional skylights. And this wraparound window is pretty spectacular with the visibility that you get. So we're gonna go down below, and as you can see, it's two gradual steps down below, and we go into a really nice bed. This bed is a Thorworship here, and so as you can see, heads on one side, feet down on this, but really great use of space, lots of cabinetry and stowage. We have a Samsung television here. We also have air conditioning controls that are behind this cabinet, and then also your third station for your Fusion control system. Again, just the appointments, the attention to detail, the woodwork and all of the grain and everything they've done is really spectacular. Large hanging locker here. We have a microwave. We have our main switching panel here and our generator start control switches behind an access door there. This is the head and shower compartment. And so we have a nice, beautiful sink here. You can see how they've kind of backlit this little glass shelving below. And again, it just is quite beautiful on all the appointments that Tierra has done here. Like how they've kind of batlit the mirror. And again, the fit, the finish from everywhere you look is pretty spectacular. So really nice designed head here. We have a shower curtain that will kind of encompass the shower, and then a Dometic, you know, quiet flush toilet. Well, this concludes the video for the 38LS. For additional information, please feel free to contact me and or find the link below for the full listing specs. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.